Hello and welcome to one of my favorite games in the world. This is Heroes of Might and Magic 3. We're gonna jump right into this. I'm not gonna explain too much right off the get-go. We're just gonna get into it and I'll let you know how it goes as we play. Gonna hit new game, single. Gonna play on one of my favorite maps, All for One. With one of my favorite factions there, Castle. Now, I'm gonna pick my hero here. Each one has their own specialty, so this guy's specialty is his archers and stuff like that. This one's got navigation, so her boats would move farther. This one's gonna have more money, etc., etc. One I'm looking for right now is this guy with prayer. Best spell in the game by far. We're gonna go to Artifact because, in my opinion, Artifact is just so much better than any of the other starting bonuses. You could also have gone for some more gold to start with, some more resources to start with. Those are cool and all, but Artifact's where it is. You and your two best friends were inseparable as youths, never doing anything without the others being present. Later, you entered the king's service, and though you were often assigned different tasks, the three of you always celebrated together when all was said and done. When the king died, however, your friendship changed. Each of you inherited a portion of the kingdom to rule, but when it came down to running the kingdom, each of you had very different opinions on how it should be done. Yesterday, the three of you stopped speaking to each other. You have decided that the only form of communication that your two friends will understand is an all-out war. So, the way that this game is played is we start off with a hero. He has an army. So these are my pikemen, these are my archers. You also have spell points, etc., just cast spells and stuff. This is the artifact that I got for the beginning. Worn on the finger, this item increases your luck and morale by +1. That's a very good artifact because luck allows you to do double damage sometimes, and morale makes it so that you can have extra attacks every once in a while. This guy starts out with basic learning, which increases his experience by 5%, which is nice. It's always good to level up faster, and wisdom, which allows him to learn third level spells. Always good, always good. Now, here, this is my castle town. We have our fort, which is where we hire all of our troops. Of course, you could also hire them from the respective thing. Pikemen from here. And that's all I have at the moment, but. And then over here, we have our tavern, which is where we would get more heroes. So this is another knight, which has her own army. She has some griffins there, which are nice. I'm not sure if I want to go for them though. It does cost 2,500 to hire a hero, which kind of sucks, but whatever. And then we have this guy. Now this guy is a completely different faction. As you can see, he's called an overlord, level 1 overlord, right up there. And he has troglodytes there, the green things, and beholders, which have the eye. Now, he is of the dungeon faction, which is not our faction, so we're just gonna quit on him. It's a hard pass for me, Captain. This is our town hall right here. Well, village hall at the moment. You go here and you decide what you want to build. So we have a lot of options to pick from here. I could go and build the archer's tower so that I can get some archers. Or I could build the town hall. Or the citadel. You know, I could build a lot of things, essentially. I could even upgrade my guardhouse so that my pikemen are stronger. Now, at the start of the game, my opinion, it's always the best to start with your economy. You build the town hall, now you're making 1,000 gold per day. Costs 2,500 to build it, but in 3 days, you've got that back. Did I say three? I meant a lot more. Make it six. Because we used to only make 500 per day. Now we make 1,000. That's a profit of 500 every day. Boom. Money. Alright, now we're going to go ahead and recruit my pikemen here. This is the maximum arrows. There we go. And now they're in my army. Cost me money for that, though. 60 per troop. And I got 14 of them. Yikes. Luckily enough, there's some gold right outside. There's 700 there. Searching a ruin, you are amazed to find a piece of the Statue of Legion. You carefully dust it off before placing it in your pack. Legs of Legion. This item, when equipped by a hero in a town, increases the growth of your second level units. So that would be my archers right there. By 5 per week. That's not bad. And now you can see that that is in my pack. And it's one of my artifacts. Down here we have all of our spare artifacts that there's no room for, in case I find something really cool, but it's but let's say that the ring spot is already taken, then I can switch them out. Alright, let's see what I'm gonna do next. Over here we have a Seer's Hut. Now what that is they will give you a reward if you bring them something. So I've spent my life buying, selling, and collecting artifacts, but lately I've been spending so much money acquiring new pieces, I can hardly turn a profit. I think I might be able to start mass producing artifacts, but I've got to have one first to copy. If you could bring me the Ring of Life, I will reward your efforts. Ring of Life. Increases the health of all your units by +1. Now if you look at the units, each of them has a health amount. So this one has 10, and this one has 10. So then they would all have 11. And that's per troop, so this one would then have 60 points of damage before it dies. They've also got defense, which will minimize the amount of damage we take. So instead of dealing 60 to kill all my archers, you would have to deal 66. Which is almost a whole nother 10 right there. I mean, it's a good artifact. I'll give it that. Now, over here we have a scholar. In my opinion, scholars, they're kind of like a 50-50 shot of actually being helpful. You might get a good skill from them. You might get an additional attack skill or some defense or what have you. Or you might get a skill that uses up one of these slots that is useless. Here's hoping we get something nice. Armorer. Hey, now that's not bad. Reduces all damage inflicted against the hero's troop by 5%. Now these skills can all be upgraded. So this one's basic right now, but just like any other one. But when I level up, I can then use the level up to upgrade it. Alright, so let's take a look and see here. These are some enemies here that I could fight. That's why it turns into a sword, my cursor there. But I don't think we have enough troops yet just to risk fighting anything yet. So we're going to go over to these. We just got a spell. That's always cool. In exchange for your protection, they agree to teach you a simple spell, Slow. That's a good spell. I like having that because it slows down the enemy troops, makes it harder for them to get to you. Now, we've used up all of our movement, and we've already built. We can only build one per day, so then we have to end our turn. And now it's day two. We're going to go here. For 1,000 gold, you will have your choice of increasing your knowledge or learning to better focus your powers, so we can get spell power or knowledge. Now what knowledge does is it gives me 10 spell points per point of knowledge. So I have 2 points of knowledge right now. I have 20 spell points. What spell power does makes it so that it will be stronger when I cast a spell. At this point, I think I'm gonna go with knowledge, because knowledge is power. But also, yeah, it's good to have more mana points. Eventually, it'll get to the point where it's like, alright, cool, I got enough mana, let's get some power. But right now is not the case. We've got a fairy ring here. Look at that. I gained some luck for my next battle. Okay, cool. So once I'm done with my next battle, that'll be gone. Got a treasure chest here. After scouring the area, you fall upon a hidden treasure cache. You may take the gold or distribute it to the peasants for experience. Oh, you gotta go experience every time. Yeah, gold's kinda cool and all, but look at that. Experience. That's gotta be a level up right there. Boom, let's go. Now I could go ahead and upgrade my wisdom. Allows me to learn fourth level spells. That would be cool. But there's also basic luck here. Now I'm not gonna get these level spells for quite a while, because I need to get to a fourth level mage's guild. I don't even have level one yet in my town. So I'm gonna go with basic luck for now, because I can always upgrade that later. But this one, it's a one in a lifetime shot of it actually showing up. Let's go with that. Campfire. Nice. Some gold and some sulfur. That's something I forgot to mention. These are all of your resources here at the bottom. Fuck off. The bottom of the screen. Bottom of the screen. Bottom of the screen. We got gold here. You know what? Screw it. There. We got our gold here. We got our gems. And then our crystals. Our sulfur. Our ore. Our mercury. And our wood. These are all used to build stuff. Here. Now, I got a build for today. I would build the city hall, but as you can see, requires mage guild level 1, marketplace, and blacksmith, and 5,000 gold, which is amazing. Alright, so I gotta build the marketplace, the mage's guild, and the blacksmith. I'm gonna start with the mage's guild, because I gotta start getting those spells in. Like I said, with the wisdom, gotta start getting those. We got that. Let's go over and check this scholar. An attack! That's very nice. Gonna go to this Shrine of Magic Incantation. Shield! Nice. Reducing the amount of damage received from hand-to-hand attacks. By hand-to-hand attacks, they just mean melee. So anything that isn't ranged. Swords. Spears, you name it. Fountain of Youth gives me additional morale and allows me to cover additional ground. So as you can see, this green bar here, that is my how much I can move for the day. And it just went up. We're gonna go to this learning stone here. Got some more experience. Very nice, very nice. Oh, gotta go basic earth air magic. Allows me to cast air spells at a reduced cost, which is amazing. Always like going for the magic skills. Because the spells can really turn the tide of battle. From the top of the observatory, you can see distant lands. Look at how much my sight just grew. I can see everything. This is cool. The windmill right here. That'll give us resources every week. We're gonna go in here, build a blacksmith. That'll give us some artillery. Ballistas. Very cool. Very cool. Now, we're gonna go over to this windmill, collect some of those resources that I was talking about. And see what goes on. And now we're gonna go to this Hut of the Magi. You enter a rickety hut and talk to the magician who lives there. He tells you places near and far which may aid you in your journey. So what that allowed me to do is I've just taken a look at this guy right here. I've seen essentially a smaller version of this, but through this one's eye. Gives me some sight, lets me look around, see what's going on. That way if any enemies come through here, I'll know about it. Okay, grab some wood, go to the witch hut. Witch hut will give me a skill, which is always cool. Marketplace. By the time it's week 2, we should have some armies ready. Every week you get new. Aw, oh, fuck. Eagle Eye? Really? Literally one of the only useless skills, in my opinion. Fuck. Alright, well, it happened. We're gonna go back home. We can't fight anyone yet. Not quite. These guys, maybe. Anyways. City Hall. That'll give me some extra money. Maybe I'll just go up here and grab these real quick. Alright, Bethel or Citadel too. Because we need the castle for the capital. Mercenary camp gives me an attack. Very cool. Marletto Tower gives me a defense. Campfire. Shipwreck. Now that's going to have undead in it. Alright, let's head on home. Gonna build the castle. Now if you notice, building those increase my creature growth as well. Get them per week, and instead of 14, now I'm getting 28. It's the last day of the week. So tomorrow, I'll get, today I should say, I'll get 28 more pikemen. Boom, now I've got 59. Oh, 10 off from the magic number. Oh well. Now we can build the capital. Get some real money. Look at that, 2,000 to 4,000. Now we got an economy base. I'm gonna go fight these guys. They wanna join me. Yeah, I mean, free troops, why not? I'm with those free troops. I mean, they're not of my faction, obviously, but they're of the Conflux faction. But that's fine. I'm gonna use them as cannon fodder anyways. Now, we're gonna go fight these imps now with our newly found troops. They're trying to run away. But let's show you some gameplay here. This is battle mode. Now, this darkened area is everywhere that these guys can move. These ones are clearly highlighted with the yellow. Now, we have our options. Retreat, surrender, auto combat. I never use that. It sucks. These buttons tell you what happened throughout the battle. Then we can cast spells. We can wait. Makes them wait until the end of the turn. Or we can make them defend and skip their turn entirely. So we're going to go ahead and hit defend for now. Take a defensive stance and gain plus one defense skill. Now that's not permanent. It's permanent for until they get, until they attack or move or anything, but for now, but it's mostly temporary. Now, with the pikemen, I don't want any of my faction getting hurt by these guys. These guys are of the Inferno faction. Now, you may notice that these guys are different, but still kind of similar. It's because these guys are the unupgraded version of these guys. If you look, can see that these guys have a little bit more speed. and more attack and defense. Other than that, they're not much different. But wait, what's this? If you look right under the bird, which is the morale, and the skull and horseshoe, which is the luck, you can see this one has nothing, but this guy says magic channel. So that means that this guy also has a skill, a little ability that it does. It does nothing right now, but in a battle where I would be against Hero, that means that every time I cast a spell, this guy's gonna steal some of my mana. Which is pretty cool. Especially for first level, first tier troop. Anyways, moving on. We're gonna move this guy away from the action. Because I don't want him getting hurt. That guy moves forward. Now this guy is an archer. So, yeah, he can shoot things. So he doesn't have to move. In fact, I don't really want him to move, if I can help it. Now, if you notice, there's a broken arrow cursor there, but there's a full arrow there. That means that here it's going to do full damage, whereas here it's only going to do half damage, because this guy is further away, and he has an obstacle in the way. So I'm going to go with the full damage, and that deals... This is when these come in handy. 18 damage. Four of them perished. Not too bad. Now we're going to move in with our pixies because they're in our range. Nice. Now I can defend with this guy, but with 59 of them, pretty sure I'm going to be able to kill them all in one shot. Done. And that's the battle. Got 117 experience. Not bad. Gonna grab my winnings. Witch hut. Oh, fuck. Really? Navigation? There's literally nowhere to be in a boat on this one. On this map. Some maps, navigation, yeah, it's kind of cool because then you can boat around faster, but not this one. This one's not very helpful. I'm gonna buy this and get some archers going. Grab this Redwood Observatory. Now I can see a bit more. Nice. There's a town down here. That is of the Rampart faction. And over here we have Town of Tower. So I have a lot to work with here. Got to have one first to copy. If you could bring me the vampire's cowl, I will reward your efforts. Some experience. Advanced learning. It's pretty cool. Gives control of the ballista to the hero, allowing two shots with a 50% chance to inflict double damage. Ooh, there's a ballista waiting for me at home at the blacksmith. I'll go with that. Magic well to replenish my mana. And that's the end of my turn, so I'll just go and build the barracks, and that'll be that. And done. Now my mana is at 50, because I'm at 5 knowledge, 50 points of mana. Pack of zombies. I could probably take them now, but I'm going to go home and grab my troops, just to be sure. I'm going to grab our swordsman that we just bought the thing for, and grab a griffin tower. Got him in there. Need the ballista too. Alright, got some spells from our mages guild. And we can build any more today, so we're gonna go fight the zombies. And they wish to join. Oh, for fuck's sakes, I'm running out of room on my hero here. Well, we got some treasure chests. A bit of experience to go around. Interesting. Advanced learning or advanced armory? That's a tough call. I think I'm gonna go with learning. So that I can level up faster. And just like that, I've leveled up again. We're gonna go advanced air magic. Reduced cost and increased effectiveness. Very cool. Makes it so that my air spells will be faster. Not faster, what am I trying to say here? Stronger. Got the monastery for some more troops. Come on over here to fight some harp. Oh my god, they're joining me too. Alright. Now, the problem with getting a lot of people from different factions is the morale kind of suffers sometimes. If you look, four troops of four alignments, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 2, yikes. Undead in the group, minus 1. So this guy's giving me a lot less morale. Oh well, what are you gonna do, right? However, this guy is unaffected by morale. Which means, pretty much, he doesn't give a shit. He's dead. It don't matter. Obelisk. Get a piece of the puzzle, which will lead you to the Grail. Pretty much, you get the Grail, you win the game. Essentially. Or you could just kill everyone. I usually just kill everyone. It's more fun that way. Chests. Badge of Courage. Increases my morale by plus 1. Good, I needed more morale. There we go. They're still suffering a little bit, but that's okay. Once we use this cannon fodder for the shipwreck, perfect. Once we use up this cannon fodder, then we shouldn't have any problems. What can we use here? Now, if you notice the little leaf here, the little water there, and the clouds. That essentially is their type. So this will show all our earth spells here. Got slow, stone skin, and shield. Then we got our air spell. We only have one, but we do have advanced air magic. So that means that it's more effective. Damage is 10 points more than basic. Nice. We also got our fire spells. I only got one, because magic arrow, if you notice, it's in all of the magic spells. Of course, there are other spells that deal damage that are strictly water, like ice bolt, or strictly air, like lightning bolt, etc., etc. Got cure, prayer. I need to get expert water magic so that I can get prayer. Really effective. I don't think I need any spells, but maybe slow might help. No, we're gonna save our mana. Undead, regenerating. Now what that means is that when they start their turn, all their health gets regenerated. Any of them that died, though, are still dead. Which is kind of okay. So essentially, I have to kill at least one of them before their turn, or else all my attacks are just useless. With how many armies I have, though, that's not a problem. I'm gonna defend with this guy. Nice. Just completely demolished them. Kill some pixies. Oh, good luck. Always good. There he goes. Now, if you notice, this guy has 6 health left. When he starts his turn. Oh, not right now. Okay, he didn't kill any. Good. Nice. Okay. It's a good thing I defended. Oh, there's the bad morale. He just lost his turn. He's almost dead, but he's not dead yet. I can shoot someone. We're gonna shoot this guy. Get him off our griffins. Get away from there, you bastard. This guy'll probably die with this strike. He's down. He's back up to 18. But I got a lucky shot, so maybe able to kill him. Nice. Lost 9 pixies. I don't really care, because they're the wrong faction anyways. And we got 3,000 gold from it, which is always cool. Alright. Now you may have wondered, what the fuck is this big old skull right in the middle? That's a subterranean gate. Pretty much it allows me to go underground. What do I need for this? I need a lot more wood. A lot more wood. So I think I'm gonna start with this. Give me 3 more griffins per week because it's the end of the week anyway. This way, next tomorrow I'll get 17 griffins. Automatic. Rat. Fight these guys. These are the upgraded version of the pixies that I have in my army. They're essentially the same, but I think they have a little bit more health. These guys have 3. Nope, they have the same amount of health. But they do have no enemy retaliation, which is kind of shitty to deal with. Oh, you're dead. Nope. Can't quite reach him. Yes, kill them off. Oh, he only did 1 damage. Shit. Need to do it another 2 times. Ah, well, let's finish this battle. Give me some experience. 79, not bad. Again, 10 points off the fucking magic number. God damn. Still can't build the training ground. I need more wood, but I did just get a sawmill, which will give me 2 per day, which is nice. However, I'm gonna have to wait a long time. I only got 3 right now. So let's build something else. Now we got plenty of ore. Let's build the upgraded guardhouse. Look at that. Picture changed. Completely different troop. We went from pikemen to halberdiers. Now they got an axe on there. Hashtag not sponsored. Buy all our troops. And that's the end of that. Look at that. Now that is how a faction is supposed to look. Never mind this bullshit. Alright, let's go down here. See if we can find any wood. Underground, not likely though. That costs wood, so I'm gonna leave that be for now. We're gonna get these guys instead. Double click on that and upgrade them. Done deal. So, what is the point of actually upgrading these guys? Well, it makes them a bit better. These guys, 4, 5, 1 to 3, 10, and 4. These guys are better, just objectively. Got more speed, they've got more attack and defense, and they deal a bit more damage from 1 to 3 to 2 to 3. It's a pretty good trade, I'd say. But these guys retaliate twice, so you get attacked once, they hit back, They get attacked again. They hit back. But after that, they just keep getting attacked. It's fine. They're just going to sit there and take it. As opposed to these guys, which only retaliate once. But these guys have unlimited. So an entire faction, an entire army could come and attack them. And they just keep attacking back. Of course, eventually they go down, but still. The point is there. Alright. Gonna grab some mercury. Ooh, imps. Another battle to fight. Grab these guys. Let's see what these guys get. From nothing to strikes twice. So they'll attack, get retaliated on, and then attack again. Always fun. Not for the enemy team. I like castle because it focuses around that kind of lot of attack heavy. A lot of times they attack back or they attack again. There's a lot of that in there. High morale is also a big thing for castle. I'm gonna fight these imps. My precious. Well, he must have something on him. I know exactly what it is, but we'll leave you guys in the dark for a bit. I don't need those. We're gonna fly straight in. I don't even care. I want these guys gone. See, that's why. I want them gone. Just get rid of them, please. I could dismiss them, but that would be a waste of free troops. Whereas this way I can fight faster, with less chance of losing armies that actually matter. He's gonna take a big hit from that. Eesh. Now they'll just sit there and attack my pixies while I can just sit back and shoot at them. Nice. Done. There's the ring of life. I think I got wood from there. That came out wrong. Don't quote me on that. Man, everything costs wood in this place. Except the resource silo, but it costs a lot of money. Now, what the resource silo does is it gives me a bit of extra resources. A bit of wood, bit of ore, what have you. What was that? Looks like an enemy hero just came through there and then went right back. Gonna get this going. Red Border Guard. Now I can't cross through that yet. I need the red Keymaster tent before I can do that. Alright. Another couple days and I can get that. Ah, screw it. I'm gonna get this. Get some zealots. Oh, they don't have an additional... Oh yeah, they do. No melee penalty. So that means that these guys, when they're... If they get attacked, let's say, by a melee troop, and they have to attack back, they're still gonna do their full damage, whereas these guys would do half damage. Which is cool. It's not a bad thing to have. It's always good. I'm gonna head on home. Oh, wrong button. I just clicked on the quest log. We're gonna bring the Ring of Life back to this guy. Mm-hmm. If I give him The Ring of Life, I'll get 5,000 experience, hell yeah. Wisdom, Air Magic. Ugh, really? I have to choose between these two? Alright, I'm gonna go fight these Obsidian Gargoyles. Gargoyles, sorry, not Gargoyles. I can get it! Let's go, boy! Could also get Angels, but we're gonna leave that for next. Next time. And that'll end this week. I'm gonna fight these guys. Alright, I'm gonna use up these guys to kill. Use up the retaliation. And then we'll defend. Gonna go in with these guys. Now this guy doesn't have a retaliation to use. And they can just take the damage. Always cool. Points extra. Yeah, sure, I'll do that. Move him a bit closer. Maybe he'll attack him instead. My troops. Nope, that's a hard pass from him. Ah, I lost a griffin! See, that's exactly what I was trying to avoid. I didn't lose another one. That's good. Oh, I had 2 health left. Yikes. That could have been bad. I like them. I like the strike and return routine. Makes it so that they can go in, attack, and then get the fuck out. GTFO. We lost our pixies. Good. Workshop. I could recruit gremlins. I'm not going to, because that's the wrong faction. That's Tower. I could get the angels, but I have to buy my troops. And now I have 5,000 gold left, so I'm going to have to wait a little longer for the angels. But I've already almost bought everything. Well, I got to get more Mage Guild levels, but essentially I've almost bought everything. He's back, and he's hungry for blood. He is dungeon. Going up against fire elementals? I don't think he's gonna do it. He doesn't have enough for them. Fire elementals are 4th tier of the complex. Really? 1 crystal? Well, thank you. Let's go fight these golems. The thing I like about fighting golems is they're really slow. Whoa. How did you get out of there so quick? Alright. I don't think you're gonna fight those guys to get to me. Not yet, anyway. Alright, we're gonna move our zombies in there. So that we can get rid of our undead, which are just destroying our morale. Destroying it completely. End with everyone else, and our zombies are gonna go in. Like, just look at how slow those guys are moving. Like, it's gonna take forever for them to get here, honestly. Look at that. 15 archers shot these guys, and only dealt half their damage. Look at how much health they have, and a lot of defense, too. It'd be useless to use spells against these guys as well, because they have magic immunity. Well, not magic immunity, but magic resistance. Damage from spells reduced by 75%. That's pretty amazing. Gonna fly these guys up here. Get them out of range. Get everyone out. really. So that only the zombies are being punched in the face. Lucky shot. Nice. He is surrounded. Christ. Gonna move literally everyone out of there. Out of dodge. Ah, he can make it to my swordsman. That's unfortunate. How much damage does this do? 10 to 15. There's a 50% chance of it doing double damage, so maybe that's today? Oh, it doesn't matter, I got good luck anyway. 37. So I guess it did do double damage. Good thing these guys have so much health. Can't reach him, can you? You can reach him. Shit. See what I mean about this being a strategic game? I just lost a whole fucking swordsman. I might as well stay here and kill these guys. This guy will kill this one, no problem. Done. Shoot that one, done. Now these guys will just have at it. Done. Done deal. Now. No? Really? He's still alive? Done. Fuck off. 14 damage. He had one health left. What's this? Charm of mana. Helps you recover one extra spell point per day. Yeah, cool. I don't have anything else in the way, so might as well have that. Negates all morale bonuses during combat for both you and your opponent. Now that is something I don't want on me. I'm gonna put that aside. Because right now I have good morale. I mean, it's neutral currently, but what are you gonna do? Anyways, another piece of the puzzle. Let me go find this star axis here. I think I'll buy the Mage's Guild. Yeah, probably the best move there. More spell power, very cool. And I'm gonna go home before I go and lay siege to this town here. Upgrade my archers. Now, shoots twice. See what I mean? A lot of attacks. Multiple attacks here and here. Multiple retaliations with this guy. This guy also gives you morale, which is cool, but we don't know that yet. Shh. Upgrade my Mage's Guild so that when I get there, I'm gonna have the best spells. All of the spells, the best of spells. Alright. I'm gonna have to get rid of these guys. Otherwise, there's no room in my army. It's unfortunate, but it has to happen. And there we go. Look at that. Only one little blotch. But that'll be fine for now. Look at that. Back to good luck. Or good morale. I already have good luck, but still. Good morale. Now if I have this on, all of a sudden, neutral. That's why I don't want it. Oh shit. All my skills are used up. I only have air magic, so I better get some good air spells here. Of course it's all water. Ice Bolt, Frost Ring, Fortune, that's an air spell. But, ugh. Oh well. Shit. What are you gonna do, I suppose? Alright. I think I'll just sit back and wait for a couple days here. Oh, I gotta get this gem pond. Storm elementals. Those are shooters. I'm gonna let them just go away. Why did I go right back? Cool, get some gems. Got a fucking eagle eye there. Bullshit. And we're gonna go home. Can I build anything? Yeah. Come on, air spells. Let's go! Town portal. That's cool. I'm okay with that. Huge blast of fire. Nice. And with that, we're now on month 2. That's going to end it for this video. Join us next time when we lay siege to this town.